Hello, welcome to Gentech Networks CompTIA Cyber Security classes. This classes is especially for those students who are new to cyber security, want to learn what's CompTIA Cyber Security, and want to start their career in ethical hacking and information security. So for those, they are specially designed course which is CompTIA Cyber Security Plus. Okay. First, let me give you an overview, a roadmap, how it's actually work, which course you should enroll first, and then which one you should start, and how you should enroll in that later course. So let me start, just a second. Okay. So if you have basic knowledge of computers, everything know about, you know how to use operating system, and you know how to a different component of Windows operating system and their security overview. So that then you should choose Security Plus. But before Security Plus, there's a special another course which a course which is CompTIA. A Plus. This course is for those who don't have any working knowledge of computers, who want to learn computers, basics of computer, basics operating system, using operating system, okay, Windows and technologies and all the IT, and want to just start in the IT, okay. This course is for those, the CompTIA A Plus, okay. After CompTIA A Plus, there's another course, which is CompTIA Security Plus. The CompTIA Security Plus is for this course is for those who have knowledge of IT, basic knowledge of IT. They have worked in cybersecurity, operating system, and as an IT. Okay, so basically, if I say if you have done, you have done CompTIA A Plus, or you have, you should have this level of knowledge, which they teach in A Plus. Okay, and this is for those. Now you were in IT and now you want to enroll in cybersecurity. You want to do a job change, okay? Do a job change and you want to do cybersecurity ethical hacking. Okay, so this course is for you because when you want to start in cybersecurity, okay, when you want to start, want to work in ethical hacking or security. So CompTIA Security Plus is for those people who want to learn what's basics of security, what are the security terms which you should know that work in security and cyber security, that people do the work cyber security people do, and what they actually secure, and what type of attack you have to defend, and as a security analyst. Okay, and now after Security Plus, there is ethical hacking. This is a little advanced than CompTIA Security Plus. Advanced why? Because here, now you get to know about security measurement. Okay, you know to you get to know about all the security terms which people use in cybersecurity. Okay, for example, malware, rootkit, operating system, memory management techniques. Okay, and process execution. Backdooring an operating system, okay, injecting a backdoor in an executable file. So for this thing we learned in ethical hacking, but the term we are going to use, you should be familiar, okay, like backdoor, virus, worm, trojan, certificates, these things, where they are actually necessary, these things you get to know about in this okay, security plus. And when you are done there, you have learned every security term, then you have to move in this little advanced. Okay, this is little advanced topic, subject, or I should say course in ethical hacking. Ethical hacking is little advanced, where here we do open source intelligence, we do information gathering, we do exploitation of network, of system hacking, all those things which are little advanced. Okay, ethical hacking, to be an ethical hacker, you should have a knowledge of this level. Okay, this level of knowledge, computer security plus. Okay, and ethical hacking, when you are done ethical hacking, after ethical hacking there are other courses like threat hunting, other topics like threat hunting. Okay, like threat hunting, malware analyst, okay. So in one term I will say that these are for defending, okay, defending the attacks. Okay, okay, so these are a little advanced, okay, because these are related to incident response, threat hunting, malware analyst, and reverse engineering. Such topics are little advanced than ethical hacking. So here is the roadmap. You should have IT knowledge of this level. Okay, you should have security knowledge of this level. Then you will move in ethical hacking, and then you will move in these courses. Okay. So let me erase. So CompTIA Security Plus, we learn about the basics of security. Okay, as we know, this is for beginners. Okay, so first we will learn about the basics security terms. Okay, basics of security, the terms we need to use in cyber security. Okay, like first of all, the malware. What is malware? So we'll start with basics of IT terms. Okay. The first thing is the types of malware. Types of malware. Okay, so malware is any file, and could be any file which can harm your PC, which can install a keylogger or install a malicious software, another malicious software without even you don't know about it, that something has been installed in the background. Okay, so and they can also corrupt your data. So there are a lot of category inside a malware. Okay, malware, there are a lot of category inside a malware. For example, a rootkit, a Trojan horse, a backdoor, a bootkit, a ransomware, so, and one more, adware. Okay, So we will learn about all of them one by one. Okay, so let's start. Start with Trojan horse. Trojan horse. What a Trojan horse. It can be a normal sorcerer. Okay, let's write it down. It can be a normal sorcerer pretending to be something else but in the background it will work as a malware. That means a Trojan horse can be a normal software, but in the background, okay, suppose you have downloaded a crack software, okay. For example, a software crack. A pirated software, that is a pirated software. Okay, it can be something like downloaded from a malicious website or not, and that's not a trusted source. Download a software, for example, you have used some third party site or torrent site to download the software. And it will work like a normal software. Okay, so you want a key for another software. Okay, for a tool, and it claim to be that it will activate the software on a computer. Okay, and when you will click it in the background, it will open a connection. Okay, and it will open a connection and try to establish a server. Okay, establish a network on the server side of its own command and control. Command and control, which in short we also say C2 server. Okay, that means command and control. Okay, command and control means it is the server which will give control or give command to the malware, which looks like a Trojan horse, but in give command to the malware, and it will do such that, like downloading some documents from the victim computer, downloading some software or something, some personal private data from the victim computer. Okay, so this can be a Trojan horse. Okay, this is Trojan horse, and it is really dangerous. So that's why people recommend not to use such crack or anything, verifying anything before installing. Okay, so for example, we will also see how should we verify anything before installing. Okay, so that we can actually see it's not a Trojan horse, it's a clean file, no one has infected it. So another term is a virus, a normal virus. Okay, a normal a virus can be anything. Okay, if it can corrupt your data. Okay, it can corrupt your data. It can destroy your data, delete your file. Data, delete your files. Okay, it can harm your operating system. Okay, which can prevent loading your OS or Windows properly. Okay, so these things will harm your computer and corrupt the data. And the system, it can be really dangerous because yeah, and these things are easy to detect. Okay, and like whenever you open some files, open a virus. So after that, your computer becomes slow. It will take start taking up so much of RAM or CPU resources. Okay, computer resources that you will not able to normally use a computer. Okay, anything which actually a virus. Yeah, like it will just corrupt your data and harm your file on your CPU computer, your operating system will start malfunctioning. Okay, let's erase it. So after virus, there's rootkit. Rootkits are really a dangerous type of malware. It actually sits inside the kernel level and it can give command to your operating system. It can sit in and receive data and send data. Okay, it is not very easy to detect. Okay, that's why and on earlier day rootkit was on Linux for Linux system. Rootkit was earlier designed to like whenever system stop responding to work with so rootkit will. Can help with system task, system admin task. Okay, that was the purpose of rootkit. But later, the malicious actors have start creating rootkit to take over the control of the operating system, so they can make the computer do any task. Okay, give the computer any command, like make they can use the computer as a what's the boat. Okay. So suppose you have a rootkit inside your computer. Okay, so this rootkit can give this computer a command to send a lot of traffic to some website. Okay, they started sending a traffic to a website. Okay, it can be used as a zombie PC. Okay, a zombie or what's the word we can use here as a bot. Okay, as a bot to automate something such things. Okay, to do malicious attacks, to send lot of traffic, to do a DDoS attack. Okay, DDoS attack we learn about that, but to do such harmful activity. Okay, so this type of rootkit can make a normal PC and turn them to a zombie server. That means they will not in control of the operating system owner. Okay, of the PC owner, those will be in control of the rootkits. Another one is adware. Now adware is what? It sits inside your computer. Okay, it can be a normal program. It will be installed in your computer and sit. Whenever you try to visit some website, it will show ads on all over your screen. Okay, whenever you try to visit some website, see some website, it will sit on inside your ad and it will show advertisement on all over your screen. You will not able to work. Okay, whatever website you're trying to visit, it is showing you advertisement. Even a normal screen on this home screen of Windows, you will still get the advertisement. So that are such thing which can prevent some you to do any work. Okay, we are doing this for theory, but we will learn about it in practical also. Okay, So these are adverts which can actually take your CPU resources, RAM, okay, and they can show you unwanted ads, advertisements. Okay, so this is for current video. We will learn about those other type of malware in the next topic. Okay, see you in the next topic. Thank you. Goodbye.